What's going on, y'all? It's your boy. We about to do a video. We finna get it started. Today we playing Conan Exiles. Get right into it. So I fuck with Conan Exiles. You know, I used to play it a lot, but I fell off. But we gonna get back into it. I'm not finna read all of them. I'm finna just browse through them and pick one. So get right into it.
Behold, bonded one, the very boundaries of civilization. Beyond the passage of our highways, lie the wild places of the world, where Ante.
I am beaten, left to rot among the ruins of the past. There are others here, slaves. Bandits and cannibals.
So in the beginning, you basically want to get all your journeys.
Some of them try to.
So I'm gonna be playing the game, kind of showing y'all what y'all need to do
the rocks and
for new viewers, and then later on we'll just keep playing.
I cannot go on. The life that I left behind.
So right now, the sun Jay is your journeys. These are like your quests. You want to try to complete them all.
Denied me.
Chapter 10 is obviously gonna be your last quest that you kind of want to do.
Past the ghost fence.
Even though you're going to be completing like at random times to complete different ones, so it's like
last of my water
not always just gonna be on chapter one. So you may do something
stranger
that's in chapter three, and you're not even done with chapter one, basically.
You truly are.
With my stats, these are your feats. This is where you're gonna be learning shit. So we get the sword, the skirmisher. Those are the main two I go. Oh, bruiser and skirmisher. Oh, we get regular housing. Box maker, primitive cooking. That's basically it that we can learn right now. I guess the skinning knife. Alright. And then these are your points. So basically, higher you level up, more points you get. And you can put them in like strength, agility, fatality, grit, encumbrance, accuracy, and survival. So strength obviously determines how much damage you do in melee. Agility is to measure your ability to act after a dodge. It'll also direct effect on armor. Vitality determines the size of your health pool. Accuracy determines the damage that you will do with ranged weapons. Grit determines the size of your stamina pool. Encumbrance is the measure of how much you can carry. And survival is a measure of your ability to live in harsh conditions. This affects how easy you metabolize food. So I mean, that's your basics. And then so each one has their own like advancements. So you hit a certain advancement and it gives you a ability. So like say for this, for example, thuggery, every blow you strike with a blunt weapon deals 100% more consecutive damage. And that's like that for every single one. We're gonna keep going. Leave this one. Drink. And we're basically gonna we have done them all for right now. I do climb? I don't know. And different things give you different levels. There we go. So doing your journey is obviously they're gonna give you levels, but almost everything you do in this game is gonna give you a level. And stamina in the beginning runs out very quick, so whenever you get into battles you want to make sure that you're watching your stamina pool, also your health pool. this thing ain't nothing, it's just you can't hit it, none of that. These books don't really matter, I just like...
Gods curse this sandstorm. We were forced to take refuge before the wind scoured the skin from our faces. There is something in the storm. Beasts. We hear the skittering of their paws outside the ruins, and their howls mingled with the screaming winds. The men are scared. I've put them to work crafting rudimentary weapons and torches from the loose stones and rough plants that dot this place. I've yet to meet a beast that liked fire, or the bite of the axe.
A bunch of stones gone. And wonder if there's a sandstorm coming or not. Well, it seems like. Oh. Okay. Not want to be in a sandstorm. Where are we on the map? Okay, so we're more towards the jungle side of things. So there's base location around right here. I want to look into. We'll probably head there. Get a little bit more levels. Hope this ends up. Get a full armor set. So over there, that's basically your just spawn area. It goes all throughout the map. So there's one here, one here, and I like this one or something. Yeah, so there's a bunch. And then this is your beginner area. I wouldn't really say this is the beginning area. This right here is your beginner area. And it goes to like medium, all throughout right here. And it gets harder, and then up top is gonna be your hardest, all the way up to the volcano. And this is gonna be your hardest region. There's bosses throughout, so you can work on trying to fight all the bosses. But right now, we're going to grab all the tools and weapons. I normally rock two weapons. I like the pike and the daggers. We're gonna rock. Fight these dudes right over here. I'm a little rusty. They're fucking me up, man. Hey, get better. Hey, get back into my mojo. Okay, so they messed me up. I'm not gonna lie to you, they messed me up. Pickaxe gets barked from the tree. An axe gets wood from a tree. Nothing different with stone. Just get less using a pickaxe. And you get regular. Interesting mechanic is just climbing. So when you go down like ledges or whatever, slide down them. I like. Yes, aloe. Aloe. Sorry, potions. I guess. Get a cleaver. Get some meat. I'll put potions in me. Big help. So these are thralls. So this one right here, this one's a tanner. So if you put it on your tannery, basically just makes your stuff go by faster. What is that? I'm gonna run. This is a good idea. Look at my health, bro. I am one shot to anybody right now. Why do they still want me, man? Left their little camp alone. Get off of me. I don't want the smoke. Another potion. Those are big help, man. Alright, so we got a bunch of journeys. Damn! We have 39 unspent points. So first we're gonna get up encumbrance to the first tier. Farming grid, and then encumbrance. And then next we're just gonna upgrade strength. We need a strong boy. It doesn't go down as bad as it would. Kill this one. Daggers on us. We need meat, so I'm gonna use a cleaver that I made. Oh no, it's not done yet. I guess we'll just get knife food. We'll still get meat. We need that hide. I'm not trying to fight a gator, but man, I'm not going to. Some other things we need to do. So we need to head over about here. And there's going to be a guy, I guess you can talk to, and that will get to a point also. So we're just gonna head over there. Take out some of these motherfuckers while we're going. Daggers. The bleed effect stacks to like 20, so that is also good to keep in mind. Manage to heal a little bit more, but I don't think you can move. Yeah, you can't. So I guess when we're safe, we'll use that, but in fights, we'll use the potion. I'm gonna try out the sword. I haven't used the sword in a while. Let's try the sword. Grab that. Inventory is getting kind of full. Put some vitality, and we're gonna get agility up to 1. Upgrade vitality. Get that to 1 too. And then we'll put some more points in confidence. So now we should be able to run faster, use less stamina, and be a little, have a little more health. He's gonna give us some glands. There we go. And those we'll use way later on. But let's try the stone sword and the daggers as a combo right now. We'll stack a little bit of bleed first off, and then we'll hit them with the sword. And there is combos for weapons, so you can use certain weapons together, and they work. You know, that's basically something you just gotta figure out. It's not that hard though. Ugly little thing. I guess from spider whip on it. Alright, let's head back onto the beach. When we get on the way, we're gonna try to head to the mid-tier area. Hey, liquor. There's a guy right there.
Attack!
Oh yeah, attack me, bro. Mess with me. I thought it was an actual person for a second. Puffball mushrooms are used for something, I just don't remember what. So we'll grab some of those. Probably not gonna be as useful right now, but still. There's some iron. But we can't really use this, so I'm not really tripping about grabbing it. We'll leave her there. Like fighting. Sneak at this. So leave me alone. Turn around. That's where you need to go. Right there. Right over there. Get these. This journey done. And then we'll head over to where we want to build the base. We'll check out a couple locations if that one's not suitable. I think it's already taken. But there are four different tiers of thralls. You got your tier one, which is just regular tier one thralls. They're gonna be your fastest teaming. You got your tier two, which are your, if you're getting there, the better. Tier three are very good. You want those. And named thralls are gonna be the best. They're gonna be like the captains of the areas.
Another new
so
one, eh?
Talk to this one. You can learn things
veterans
from different
tend to
areas.
Smell just a little more like despair.
Do that real quick.
Once a sailor, now a wanderer.
We'll get some more aloe.
Think you're the only one, did you? You should go up north. There's whole cities of
good to have. Venerate cup, whatever it is. Man, this is somebody's base. There's a hyena pet. All the resources look like they were taken. There's nothing here. We're gonna keep moving. We got that done. We're gonna head that way to get to our area over here. And get some resources. It's a good area. There's iron, bark, stones. So pretty much gonna be set for a little bit. That'll be our starting area, and then we'll move on to somewhere else. Hopefully, if it's not taken. If not, then I got other places. So there are world maps that can be placed around area. And you can use those to teleport from places. So you unlock, like, they're kind of like obelisks, basically. You unlock them. I think that's the world map right there. I don't know what that is. What is it? I got no clue. Oh, this is the world map. So basically, you can add your obelisk. So that I think they are obelisk. And then you can just teleport to different places around the map. And that's how you get around fast. Like that. We're getting corruption. Which dancers can cure corruption. It's nice, but we don't have any dancers. We'll just get a little bit corrupt. Not bad. It looks to be taken. I wanna see what they're based on. You know what I mean? Oh, they have black eyes on the inside. Okay. Well, we're gonna skedaddle. The next area is gonna be up here. And then the last area will probably be up here. And then from there, we basically just gotta find somewhere. If all of those spots are taken. How's it going? Can y'all hear me? Okay, well, they didn't mess with me. That is good. We are back. I'm deciding to build a little base right over here. All the good locations are pretty much taken. Until we get more loot and gear, we're just gonna have to set up a little shish shack. I feel here's probably gonna be the best place to put it. Those dudes gave me a bunch of things, so that's cool. Like, they gave me star metal tools, which is pretty good tools. Did not mean to use a band-aid, but whatever. Might as well use the terminal supposed to game. I'm glad I got that. Well, they gave that. Community sometimes has nice people and sometimes don't always expect that. Slap the base down. Okay. this. We are here. We have your base. We're just gonna airlock it real quick. We can glitch through it, but we'll still place the foundation right there. Please, place the bed. Place the bed. Here. I'll just kind of stick everything in there. Alrighty. That's gonna be it for this episode. We'll be back. I'm gonna do some stuff, kind of off video. And, I'll kind of set the base a little bit more in the next episode. We'll work on getting some thralls, other stuff like that. But yeah, make sure y'all tune in, make sure y'all like, subscribe, and come see me again. Appreciate it. In the sunshine.